Money Monday, presented by Oklahoma Central Credit Union.
The pandemic has taken a huge toll on many families financially. This Money Monday, we're talking about ways that we can all start to recover and make some smarter decisions with our money. Here to help us out is our financial expert and good friend Paul Hood from Hood CPAs. Paul, according to a new bank rate survey, 42% of consumers with credit card debt added to it during the pandemic. Millennials were the most likely to be affected financially by the pandemic. Paul, what can folks do to start getting out of that debt that they may have accumulated over the past 18, 19, 20 months?
Well, you know, Brian, credit cards are a vehicle. It's something to facilitate timing. It should be only for timing, and people should pay their credit cards off every month. Unfortunately, we live in a great country, and we can get credit, and a lot of people live below their means. So I'm not sure how much the pandemic affected that, but I'm sure it increased it. So there's no judging. You do what you got to do. So the biggest thing is you've got to figure out a budget, figure out where your money's going. Dave Ramsey has people take envelopes and put cash in it. You've got to get your spending under control. So to get out of that debt, you literally have to not only live at your means, but live below your means so you can pay for what you accumulate on those credit cards now. So short-term pain, long-term gain. So it's time to start tightening the belt and just watching where your money goes.
Yeah, that's step one, right, is figure out what you're spending on.
That's right.
Yeah, can't eat out 5 nights a week if you're trying to pay off debt.
That's exactly right.
Yeah. Let's talk inflation. The high rate of inflation has been a big financial topic, of course, this whole year. How can we best protect our investments if inflation rates continue to go up?
Well, Brian, there are certain types of investments that are, they are actually built to mitigate inflation. You can look at that. There's certain mutual funds that'll do that. Typically, interest-bearing vehicles that are longer term don't do a great job. It's the shorter term interest type vehicles because they're going to adjust with things. But really, it's equities are the primary way to hedge against inflation because they're not tied to interest rates per se. They're tied to the economy. And as things get more expensive, then the stock that backs up the companies that produce those things typically can outpace it. If you have your money in safe products and long-term interest-bearing products, it's probably a time to reevaluate.
Okay, we have time for one viewer question. Let's go to Heather's. Heather wrote in this week saying that she has kids, they're young teenagers, and she wants to start teaching them about financial responsibility. Paul, what's your advice on how to teach kids to be smart with money?
Well, parenting sometimes can be difficult. You know, it's hard to, especially people like me that came through a life that times were tough, you know, and when you produce and your kids can have a better life, you want them to have a better life, but you're actually giving them a disservice. So don't give them allowance. Have them earn the money that for their chores. And then force them or strongly encourage them to save, you know, 20% of what they make so that they can learn that trading hours for dollars is one thing, but you don't want to spend everything you make. You know, there's a saying that, you know, if you continually eat what you kill, eventually you won't be able to hunt anymore, so you got to start saving. So teach them to save, but don't just hand to them.
That was tough for me. My grandpa'd hand me $20. We'd go to the toy store, I'd find something for $20, and then he'd be like, "What about the tax?" I was like, "What's tax?
Yeah, what's that all about?"
All right. If you have a financial question you'd like for us to talk about next Monday, if you would please send your question. You can do it right now by email to moneymonday@griffin.news. Stacia?
Thanks.